Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja, and today we're going to talk about hydrostatic pressure in the crawl space and why you should pay attention to it. Stay tuned. Okay, so I'm going to be totally transparent. I am not an engineer, nor do I pretend to be an engineer. So all of you engineers out there, please feel free to comment on the ins and outs of hydrostatic pressure, but I'm going to explain a little bit about what I do understand about it in my own words, okay? So basically, the way I understand it is hydrostatic pressure is pressure from the outside of the crawl space where the soil is pushing against the foundation wall, and it's water. So you got water in the dirt. That water is pushing against the wall, whether it's concrete or block or brick or whatever. The taller the dirt wall, the more pressure. So it's kind of like I scuba dive. So if you go down, the further you go down in the ocean, the more the pressure. Well, that's the same thing with hydrostatic pressure. If your wall is that tall, the dirt is that tall on the outside of the wall, you don't have a lot of hydrostatic pressure. But if you've got 6-8 feet of wall with dirt on the outside, the water is more likely to be forcing harder in through the foundation wall. So that's my layman's terms way of explaining hydrostatic pressure. Now, why should you care about that? Well, hydrostatic pressure can cause a humidity problem inside the crawl space. So if you've got block wall and you've got efflorescence, that's the different stuff that cinder block is made of, pushing through from the water. So all this white chalky looking stuff all over the wall is called efflorescence. That means you've got hydrostatic pressure. That hydrostatic pressure is causing a humidity problem inside the crawl space. Humidity eventually leads to mold. If you get enough hydrostatic pressure, you've got enough water to where it can eventually start to flood the crawl space. And the other thing I found is that home inspectors don't like to see hydrostatic pressure. So if you're looking to sell your house and the home inspector goes in and they see the efflorescence on the wall, even though you may not have standing water, you may get a ding on your home inspection report asking you to address the hydrostatic pressure. Well, how do you address it? You typically have to address it truly from the outside. You have to redo the outside foundation wall to keep that water from coming in. Well, I've seen instances where you've got enough hydrostatic pressure on the wall to ding on the crawl on the home inspection report, but there's no standing water. So most crawl space companies, if they see hydrostatic pressure on the wall, they're going to say, oh, well, you need a trench and a sump pump. I don't have any standing water. Why do I need a trench and a sump pump? Just keep in mind that hydrostatic pressure can eventually, over time, maybe years and years and years down the road, it's going to get worse and worse and worse and worse. And water will always take the path of least resistance. So you may one day have standing water on that wall that you got a lot of hydrostatic pressure. One of the biggest things you can do to even address hydrostatic pressure is go ahead and put vapor barrier up the wall. Make sure you've got it behind foam board and vapor barrier if you're encapsulating your crawl space. So that way, as the hydrostatic pressure comes in, it's being forced under the vapor barrier. Also, make sure you install a dehumidifier to control that humidity as it's coming in. And if you're planning on staying in the house for a long period of time, I would maybe think about investing in a sump pump and a trench, because most likely, eventually one day, you could be dealing with a water intrusion problem. If you go ahead and encapsulate the crawl space, you plan on living there the rest of your life, and then 15 years, you gotta rip all the plastic out to put in a sump pump because you didn't do it 15 years ago, it's gonna be more expensive to do that 15 years from now than it is to do it today. I said a lot about hydrostatic pressure. I think I use, maybe Kayla can count how many times I actually said hydrostatic pressure in this video. But my name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja, and I hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.